Town. Things all jump around, just like the Higley Town heroes. They all work together, making fun together. Come see the Higley Town heroes. You be Wayne, Twinkle, Kip, and Fran, all hop and pop around. Soon they'll learn about real heroes, who and why. With all the Higley Town heroes, let's all play together, save the day together. Come join the Higley Town heroes.
All warm inside. I love snow.
Me too. Hey, what are you doing?
We're imagining that we're penguins. The snowballs are chunks of ice floating in the ocean. We have to hop all the way across the ice chunks to the other side. And we can't fall in, or the lobster monster will get us.
Lobster monster?
Look at me. I'm a penguin.
I'm a penguin princess.
Oh, I'm a penguin, don't you know?
Whoa.
Don't worry, Wayne. You can do it. Just think like a penguin.
Okay. Think like a penguin. Think like a penguin. Think like a penguin. Think like a penguin.
I did it.
Whoa.
Whoa. Forget me.
What are we gonna do?
Pizza guy!
If anyone would know how to save Penguin Wayne from the lobster monster, it would be Pizza Guy.
Lobster monster, huh? Don't worry, Snow Higglies. I know just what to do. I know for a bona fide, certified, factified fact that lobster monsters love mustard and pudding pizza.
Yummers!
So he won't want to eat any penguins.
Thanks, Pizza Guy.
You're welcome, Wayne Dude. Now I gotta run. Lobster monsters aren't the only ones who like my pizzas.
I'm glad you didn't get eaten by the lobster monster, Wayne.
Me too. Only... Only I think I got snow on my jacket. It's cold. Maybe I can shake the snow out.
I don't know if that's gonna work there, Wayne. Once the cold gets in, it's mighty hard to get it back out, don't you know? The best way to chase the chilly willies away is to go indoors.
Yeah!
It's really cold.
Hi, Flappy. Did you miss me?
You kids have fun?
Playing out in the snow?
We sure did. We were penguins.
Wayne almost got eaten by the lobster monster. But then Pizza Guy saved him.
Yeah, it was fun. But now we're cold.
Well, come in and warm yourselves up. You're just in time.
To help us make pinecone bird feeders.
What are pinecone bird feeders?
Well, you see,
let me try, dear. In the wintertime, a lot of Flappy's outdoor bird friends get cold.
It's hard for birds to find food in the snow. That's why
we make these pinecone bird feeders. First, we
spread peanut butter over the pine cones
with a spatula. And then
we roll them in bird seed. And later,
we'll hang them in trees
where the birdies can eat the seeds.
That sounds great. Can we help?
Of course.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yum.
Brr.
My hands are too cold. I can't get the peanut butter on.
Yeah, brr. I'm too cold to make bird feeders.
Ooh. You know what? Sometimes exercises warm y'all up. Why don't we try doing some to get our blood a-flowing?
What are we waiting for? Let's go, let's go, let's go!
Trying to get warmer, getting nice and warm.
There's exercises that we can perform. Moving to the beat helps melt the ice. Then the shivers will stop and it feels real nice.
Go!
Hop up and down while combing your hair. Run in a circle, then run in a square.
Flap your arms to fly like a jet.
I think we might be breaking a sweat.
Make sand angels in the sand.
March much faster than the marching band.
Dance with an octopus in the warm sea.
Our body heat's moving up a degree.
Trying to get warmer, getting nice and warm. Trying to get warmer, getting nice and warm.
Trying to get warm, we're getting toasty warm.
Go!
Race a dinosaur to the finish line. Then race backwards to the starting sign.
Juggle some carrots and juggle some peas.
Oh, we're working hard to ease the freeze.
Skip with the monkey through a field of wheat.
A piece of toast gives off some excellent heat.
Carry a camel up a hill.
We're gonna get rid of the chill.
Ooh. Trying to get warm, we're getting nice and warm.
There's exercises that we can perform. Moving to the beat helps melt the ice. And the shivers will stop and it feels real nice.
Trying to get warm, we're getting nice and warm. Trying to get warm, we're getting nice and warm.
Trying to get warm, we're getting toasty warm.
Go! We're getting nice and warm.
Yay!
That was fun, but you know what? I'm so cold.
Me too.
I'm gonna put my snow clothes back on. Maybe they'll keep me warm.
A good idea, Wayne.
There, I feel a little warmer now.
Now we can go back and make pinecone bird feeders.
Oh, I got peanut butter on my mittens.
Me too.
What about you, Fran?
What? Oh, yeah, all over my mittens, don't you know?
This is hard to do with our mittens on.
I don't want to take my snow clothes off. I'll get cold.
Ooh, dearie me. We should have warmed up from snow playing by now.
You know what?
Oh, I'm getting cold, too. Maybe it really is.
Getting cold. Let's go
check the furnace.
What's the furnace?
The furnace is the machine
that makes heat to keep the house warm. But it isn't making any heat. It must be
broken.
Oh, no. How are we gonna warm up?
Oh, I know. I could get into a balloon that would take me up, all the way to Miss Sunshine. Then I'd blow kisses to Miss Sunshine. Then Miss Sunshine will blow sunshine kisses back. Mwah, mwah. Then I can catch the kisses in a jar and take them back to Earth. Bye, Miss Sunshine. And the sunshine kisses will warm us all up.
Ah. Ah. That's one sunny idea there, Twinkle. There's just one teeny tiny little problem. Balloons can't fly into outer space.
Pickles.
But if we can't get kisses from Miss Sunshine, we'll just keep getting colder and colder and colder until we turn into icicles.
Maybe we need the help of someone special.
Someone special, who could it be?
Mr. Dobbs too big for you and me.
We need some help.
But never fear, oh. It looks like a job for a Higglytown hero.
A Higglytown hero.
I'm a Higglytown hero, brave and true. I help the town with the things I do. So work real hard and you will see that you can be a hero just like me. A hero just like me. I'm a furnace repairman. I take great pride in keeping you warm when it's cold outside. So if your furnace should break down, call on me and I'll come around. Being cold is not so great, so I'll make warm air circulate. That's what my job is all about. Warm air inside, cold air out.
Could you keep a circus warm so a lion could perform?
Heat is on the way.
Can you fix up the heat so a bear can keep the beat?
Play that funky music, White Bear. Even in a winter storm, I'll make sure to keep you warm. You won't need your coat and hat. Just turn up your thermostat. I'm a Higglytown hero, bold and good. I help my friends just like I should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero, just like you. A hero just like you.
There, kids. Feel the warm air coming out of the vents? That means the furnace is working now. It's blowing heat into the whole house. You should be warm in no time.
Thanks, Mr. Furnace Repairman. Without you, things would have got really cold in here.
Just doing my job, kids. I wouldn't want you to have to wear your coats indoors all winter long.
Me neither. I'd get peanut butter on it.
But if you wear a sweater when it's cold, then an adult can turn the heat down on the furnace a little bit. That saves energy. And saving energy is a great way to be...
Higglytown Heroes!
Now we can go back to making pinecone bird feeders.
Pinecone bird feeders? That sounds like fun. Can I help?
That means yes, you may.
That's the last one.
Come and get it, birds. Look, the birdies really like the pinecone bird feeders we made.
Yeah, listen to them chirpy, chirpy, chirpy.
You know, a furnace warms our houses, but seeing the birds enjoy the bird feeders really warms my heart.
Calling all ducks.
Quack, 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 quack.
Quack, 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 quack.
Quackity quack.
Whack-a-doodle-doo.
How'd your aunt and uncle learn to make those cool duck noises, Yubi?
Aunt Melly and Uncle Zoot are in the Higglytown Bird Club. They're calling the ducks with duck calls because they want to count all the ducks that live out on Ducky Island.
Why do they need to count them?
The Bird Club keeps track of all the birds in Higglytown so they know how many there are.
Shh, shh, shh. Kids, we need to be quiet. We don't want to
scare the ducks away.
Mr. and Mrs. Yubi's aunt and uncle, there aren't any ducks here to scare away.
There's some!
Whoopsie.
Is counting ducks supposed to be fun?
It is when there's ducks to count.
Keep whistling, Wayne.
It looks like the ducks.
Like your whistle music.
Whistle louder, Wayne. Then all the ducks will hear you and come to be counted.
Good try there, Wayne. But I don't think anyone can whistle loud enough for all those ducks on Higgly Lake to hear.
Hey, I know something that plays music even louder than whistling.
Owaloopa, Papa.
Squeakaphone. We could play that for the ducks.
Hey, if we all bring our musical instruments, we could play even louder.
Then all the ducks would come to listen.
And you could count them all.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Let's go, let's go, let's go! My flylophone sounds just as good as the last time it buzzed.
Oh, and my bongo drums sound mighty funky. Yes, sir.
Woo! Yo, yo, yo! What's the scoop, Higgly Troop?
Pizza Guy!
We're gonna play at Higgly Lake so the ducks will come, and my Aunt Melly and Uncle Zoot can count them.
Can I bring my electric pizza, Lynn?
Sure. The more instruments, the better.
Totally radical! Yeah! Woo!
my Wayne-a-tone.
And I've got my flamingo cello.
Come one, come all. Bring your musical instruments and help us bring out the ducks so we can count them all.
Oh, Bouncylodeon, how I've missed you.
Our Loopa Papa Squeakaphone
is gonna sound great on the lake.
With all the instruments everyone's gonna bring, every duck on the lake is gonna wanna come listen.
Then we
can count them all. Okay, everyone.
Start your instruments.
And a one, and a two, and a ready, set, go!
Calling all ducks.
One, two, three, four.
Calling all ducks.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Calling all ducks.
Nine, ten, 11.
Calling all ducks.
Now don't you be late.
Come on, all you quacking ducks.
Over here, we want to count you up.
Come on, in, you can swim or fly.
Tell your friends and don't be shy.
Calling all ducks.
One, two, three, four.
Calling all ducks.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Calling all ducks.
Nine, ten, 11.
Calling all ducks.
Now don't you be late. Look at how those ducks are smiling.
And all these numbers I'm compiling.
Every duck come big and small. Tell your friends come one and all. Calling all ducks.
There's a merganser.
Calling all ducks.
And a pintail too.
Calling all ducks.
Here come three mallards.
Calling all ducks.
We're counting on you.
Come on all you broad-billed swimmers.
I love the way your feathers shimmer.
Come on down you.
Sing along.
Every duck come big and small. Tell your friends come one and all.
Calling all ducks.
Teals and ringnecks.
Calling all ducks.
Harlequins too.
Calling all ducks.
Canvasbacks and widgeons.
Calling all ducks.
We'd love to see you.
Calling all ducks.
One, two, three, four.
Calling all ducks.
Five, six, seven, eight.
Calling all ducks.
Nine, ten, 11.
Calling all ducks.
Now don't you be late.
Hey, the ducks aren't quacking along anymore.
Why didn't they help us finish the song?
Oh, I know. Earlier in the day, the Higgly ducks were swimming along when a mermaid came and invited them to her birthday party. So the ducks put on their diving helmets and swam down to the bottom of the lake for the mermaid birthday party.
Here, little duckies, have some pretty pink bubble gum.
But the ducks couldn't eat the pink gum because they were wearing their diving helmets. So they put the gum in their pockets to save for later. Then, after the party was over, they heard us singing. And the singing reminded them of a party. And that reminded them that they had bubble gum. So they chewed their pink bubble gum. And since their mouths were so full of gum, that's why they couldn't sing the end of the song with us.
That's a good thought to chew on there, Twinkle. But there's just one problem. Ducks don't like bubblegum.
Aw, Pickles.
But if they're not chewing gum, why aren't they quacking?
Maybe they didn't like our music.
I don't think that's the problem, Kip. I'd say these ducks look mighty peculiar.
Oh, dear. It seems as if...
The ducks are covered in oil.
There's oil all over the water.
The oil must be making the ducks sick.
Is there a duck doctor on the lake?
Is there anything you can do, Aunt Melly and Uncle Zooter?
We need to find out
where this oil came from.
And figure out how to get rid of it.
But how?
I think we need the help of someone special.
Someone special, who could it be?
This job's too big for you and me.
We need some help.
But never fear, oh. It looks like a job for a Higglytown hero.
A Higglytown hero.
I'm a Higglytown hero, brave and true. I help the
the town with the things I do. So work real hard and you will see that you can be a hero just like me. A hero just like me. I'm the environmentalist. The planet's health is my quest. When there's pollution across the land, I try to lend a helping hand. I help everyone to know the ways to keep the earth aglow. From lakes so blue to trees so green, I help to keep the whole world clean.
Can you clean a dirty shore on a beach in Ecuador?
No problem.
Or the air in a big city, can you keep it smelling pretty?
I'll do my best. Beaches, deserts, oceans too. Keep them safe, that's what I do. To keep things clean in land and air, everyone must do their share. I'm a Higglytown hero, bold and good. I help my friends just like I should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero, just like you. A hero just like you.
Can you tell where the oil is coming from, Miss Environmentalist?
The oil seems to be coming from the motorboats.
The motorboats?
There's just too many of them in the lake. They're leaking oil and polluting the water. And the oil is making the ducks feel sick.
Oh, for a while there, I was worried that they just didn't like our music.
No, they loved the music. They just didn't like the pollution in the water.
Hey, everybody! Our boats are getting oil in the water and making the ducks feel sick. What do you say we row, row, row our boats out of the lake so the water will clean up and get the ducks to feeling better?
Here we go!
Land ho!
This sign will help remind people not to use motorboats around Ducky Island, where the ducks live.
I think this is the last duck to clean off.
Now, all of the ducks are clean again.
Looks like the water is becoming clean again, too, now that the boats are out of the lake.
Thanks for saving the ducks of Higgly Lake, Miss Environmentalist.
Just doing my job, kids. And if you remember not to pollute, you'll help to keep your air, land, and water clean. And that's a great way to be
Higglytown heroes!
I'm glad the ducks are feeling better. I only wish
we could finish counting them.
I think you can. Even if you finish playing on the shore, there are so many instruments that even the ducks way out in the lake will be able to hear them.
Yay!
I just have one small request. Can I play too?
Sure. You can bounce with me on my bouncelodeon.
Okay, Higgly musicians. And a one, and a two, and a ready, set, go! One, two, three, four,
five, six, seven, eight.
Wait, there's more.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.